Now we'll talk about velocity and acceleration of central mass of a system of particle. As we know, for a system of particle having multiple objects, the position vector of center of mass is given as, we know position vector of center of mass we write as m1 r1 plus m2 r2 plus, for all masses we sum up mass moments with respect to origin upon m1 plus m2 plus, like this. This we already studied, we have taken some examples also on this. Now, if we are required to find the velocity, so obviously if other masses are moving, center of mass will also move. So we can say velocity of center of mass can be given as Vc. This Vc can be written as drc by dt. This is the time derivative of position coordinate of center of mass. So in this situation, if we differentiate it, we know all masses are constant, so only r1 r2 are changing, so this will give us m1 v1 vector plus m2 v2 vector plus and so on upon masses m1 plus m2 plus and so on. Because when you differentiate this expression, the time derivative of position vector of m1 will give us the velocity of mass m1. Similarly, time derivative of position vector of m2 will give us the velocity of mass m2. Now, this is the expression for velocity of center of mass. If you carefully have a look on this, you can see what is m1 and v1. This is the momentum of particle of mass m1. m2 v2 is momentum of the second particle, which is of mass m2. So here in numerator we can state it is the sum of momentum of all the particles of the system. So this can be written as P system. P system is the total momentum of all the particles of system divided by sum of all the masses of system from I equals to 1 to n. This itself is a very useful relation of velocity of center of mass. You can directly write velocity of center of mass of a system of particle is total momentum of system of particle divided by sum of masses in system of particle. This is the expression we use for finding the velocity of center of mass. In the similar manner, we can also calculate the acceleration of center of mass of a system of particles. As we know, acceleration vector can be written as time derivative of velocity vector. Now, as we know, the velocity vector we have just now written and the derivative of individual velocities can be written as individual accelerations. So the previous expression will get modified as m1 a1 vector plus m2 a2 vector plus and so on upon the sum of masses m1 plus m2 plus and so on. Here if you have a careful look on this expression, which gives us the acceleration of center of mass, in this numerator we can see that m1 a1 is the force acting on the particle of mass m1 according to Newton's second law. Similarly, m2 a2 is the force acting on the second particle. If we sum up all the forces acting on all the particles, we can see that if we sum up all the forces, all internal forces will get cancelled out, only external forces will left over. So acceleration of center of mass can be written as F external total acting on system divided by sum of masses mi from I equals to 1 to n. This is also a very useful relation about center of mass, which can be written as acceleration of center of mass of any system is equals to net external force on a system of particle divided by sum of all the masses in the system. So be careful when calculating acceleration of center of mass of a system of particle. Let's have some examples based on this also in coming sections.